So this is the third and longest of the how to use Blackboard Collaborate videos, where I'm showing you ways of teaching seminars via Blackboard Collaborate. This corresponds to the material in step three on the how to guide, preparing material in advance. I'm going to show you how to put PDFs, how to access Word documents and video and images while you're teaching your seminar. So this is seminar material that you would want to prepare in advance, and I'll show you how to do that. So we'll go back. This is where we left it last time. We're in the Blackboard Collaborate session that I showed you how to create. Last time round, I showed you about notification settings and session settings. This time, we're going to go to the middle of those buttons down there, which is the share content. I'm just going to make myself disappear so that you can see these. So there are things like share blank whiteboard and share camera and polling and breakout groups. I'll show you another, I'll do another video or instructions for breakout groups. I can't really show you that on my own, I'm afraid. That's impossible for me. But I want to show you share files. Now, here, clicking on share files, it's extremely easy to add files to your file folder. And this is the file folder just for this one session. But of course, because I showed you how to leave this session running throughout the course, all of my Shakespeare classes will be run from this room that we're currently in, and therefore anything I add here will be available for all four of my Shakespeare sessions. So I might in fact want to come and take stuff out, although it's useful to leave them here as well, because the students can come back in and they can still see this material. They can't take things out, but they can see it. Adding stuff is very easy. You just click on add files and you can access your Dropbox, your desktop, your documents and so on. And you simply drag them in to this gray box in the margin. But the frustrating thing is you can't add Word documents. So you have to save your Word documents as PDFs in order for them to be compatible with Blackboard. So you have to save Word documents as PDF, which is very simple. It's just save as PDF when you're in your Word document normally. And here you can see, and I've added them in advance because they take a little bit of time to download, so I didn't want you having to wait. You can see that I've added an article, a picture, and some slides. The article, I click on it, I press share now. Before it goes live to the students, you get preview slides of it down the margin so that you can check that you're about to show them the right thing. And you can also see what's coming next down the margin, which is useful. So I click on that and it appears to the student. I think an anomaly of this Zoom video is it won't show you that I'm now zooming in on this and making these bigger and smaller. You'll have to take my word for it. That you can adjust the size of those screens. I get out of that by pressing on the stop sharing button in the top right corner of this black bit. The other things that I have that I might want to be using in my seminar, I can't quite picture what seminar this is, where the picture is appropriate, but it's the two Rennies. So I just dragged this into the add files beforehand. A JPEG to show you that they work as well. I'll stop sharing them. And the other thing I've put in here, and I hope Ezra doesn't mind, I've just used Ezra's PowerPoint presentation from their excellent Syphilis in Early Modern England session. Again, you can see that I can see all the slides down the margin. Now, what I've done here is I've saved Ezra's lecture as a PDF. And again, you can just do that in PowerPoint. You can just save as PDF. The reason I've done that is Matthew Sperling pointed out to me that PowerPoint presentations tend to shift and slide when you convert them into Blackboard. the layout that you've done, and you can see that Ezra's made quite a complicated layout, and it just wouldn't necessarily stay stable as you imported it. But because I've saved it as a PDF, that effectively fixes the material. Now, a confusion here is that sometimes you are seeing things slightly differently to the students. That cuts it off for me, but the students are just seeing normal full screen there. And you can scroll through. There's different ways of scrolling through. You either click on them down the margin, or there's a little arrow here. Now, I think we're going to find, and I've been through these slides before, that some of them are stickier than others. Some of them come straight up, some of them take a bit of time to come up, and so on. Yeah, so don't be alarmed if they're not loading properly. Actually, they look like they're doing well. And you can see that Ezra's slides are complex, really great, but they could be as simple as you wanted them to be. And you simply exit stop sharing by pressing on the stop sharing, and you'll return back, and then you're visible again, and your students are visible in this main part file, this main panel. So that is sharing through sharing files. I'm going to go back to the previous panel. This is the share content panel where all the other different types of sharing were available. This last short section is going to be a little less satisfying, because when you're using Zoom to record your screen, it can't pick up secondary screens. And I want to show you now how to use YouTube videos. And it's quite difficult to show you each stage, but I'll talk you through. So to start off with, I've just shown you how to show PDFs and JPEGs and things like that. Now I want to go back from share files to the main share content menu down the side here. And I want to share application screen. Now, this is the first thing that actually won't work, I think. So I'm just going to have to very lo-fi show you. You just have to take my word for it. But here on the screen, another pop-up screen has come up, and it's giving me the options of sharing my entire screen. And if I did that, I'd be able to show Word documents, actually, if I had them set up on my computer, because I can just show anything that's on my screen if I use that. Another option that is hidden currently by this video is Chrome tab, and that's the one that I'm going to show you now. So I'm using Chrome because Chrome is good, it works well, and gives you audio. If you were using Safari, you'd find that the audio wouldn't play on your film clips. So I'm clicking on Share tab, Share Chrome tab, and it's going to allow me to go into anything that I had open here, you see, along the top of the screen. All of these obviously are Chrome tabs along the top, and you notice that one of them that I've got there is called Paul Schofield, and I'm going to just select that one to share. Now, I hope that you can see this on the video. I promise that the students could see this, even if perhaps you can't, but I think you can. I'm now going to enlarge that so it's full screen. And I'm going to play Paul Schofield.
You unnatural hacks! I will have such revenges on you both that all the world shall. I will do such things. What they are yet I know not, but they shall be the terrors of the earth.
So you can see it takes a bit more fiddling around, but that's the way that you would get in. You would go to share screen, you'd go to Chrome tab, and you'd select the YouTube video. And it works